Hello everyone and welcome back, and I am back with another tutorial on how to make 3D solar system in PowerPoint. However, it is not a complete animation. I am just rotating the earth around the sun, but you can also include another planet if you want to, but it also depends on what kind of computer you have, because if I show you this presentation, the 3D solar system with Mercury, where I have included another planet along with the Earth, and that is Mercury. If you see here, let me hide this Earth here so you may see the Mercury behind it. So I tried to include two planets in this presentation, but if I show you the slideshow, then you can see a lot of lagging in the animation. So it is very hard to make these kinds of 3D animations. If you have more than 2 or 3 3D objects, then it becomes hard to manage them in PowerPoint, because it's lag of supporting the graphic cards, as you can see here. So let me show you the preview of this presentation, where we only have the Earth rotating around the sun, and here you can see that we have this background picture, and then we have this 3D sun. Let me hide this one. That's 3D sun. If I show you the slideshow, and you can see that it is continuously rotating on its axis. And then if I show you this one, Earth front, then we also have this 3D model here of Earth. And if I show you the slideshow now, so that's just a concept of making a 3D solar system in PowerPoint. So as you can see, that this Earth 3D model Earth is moving on top of the sun, and then we have this another Earth here, which is exactly on the top of the previous one, and one of them is in the front of the sun and the another one is behind the sun. As you can see the position in the selection pan, first of all, behind all the objects we have this picture, the background picture, then we have the Earth behind 3D model, then we have the 3D sun, and then we have on top of another 3D model of the Earth. So now if I show you this slideshow, then you can notice one thing here, that the Earth is making a complete rotation around the sun, and it is coming from the back and then move in the front and then again go back, and that is what we need to learn here. So later, if you want to add more planets to it, and if your computer allow that, then you can do this. So let me show you that what I did to create this complete rotation of this 3D Earth model around this 3D Sun model, because exactly that is not possible in PowerPoint to send or bring forward a few objects during the slideshow. So if you try to search the internet for if there is a way to move the objects behind or in front of the other objects during the slideshow, so is there any way around it, so then I found these two articles. I hope you might like them if you know how to use VBA, Visual Basic, inside PowerPoint. Then you can also make a lot of great animations in PowerPoint, as I think. So it didn't work for me, but still I have given the links of these articles in the video description. You can go and check them. So there is a method of creating macros, and you can ask PowerPoint to run the macros during the slideshow. So that way you may also include these kind of commands inside the macros to change the position of objects during the slideshow, like you can send them to back or bring them to the front. So I didn't use this technique because I am not good with Visual Basic, So I tried another method and I hope you will like that. So let me show you. So if I open the animations pane, and here you can see all the corresponding animation effects that I applied to all these objects here. So first of all, as you have seen that I have taken two models of the same earth. I just replicated the 3D model of earth and created two of them. Let me change the position of this one. And you can also notice that both of these 3D earth model have the same motion path, and we have applied the circle motion path animation effect, as you can see here. So we have taken this 3D model by clicking on insert 3D models, stroke 3D models, and here you can find all the planets, Sun, Earth, Mercury, Venus. Almost all of the planets are available as a 3D model under this section. So here we have this Venus, and then you can click on insert. So I did exactly the same thing. I inserted one of the planet like this one, let's say, reduce the size, and then I go to the animations, add animations, more motion path, and then I applied the circle motion path to them and change the size and position as I require, as you can see here. So we did the same for the earth. So basically we have two earth models, and why I am using two different models of the earth for a single animation, that's because we want one 3D model of earth to move behind the sun and one in the front of the sun. So that is why we have taken two earth models here. So first of all, what you are seeing here, I have applied disappear effect at the beginning of this animation for the earth front object, 3D object, and then we see that earth behind is having a motion path, circle motion path, with a duration of 5 seconds and is in continuous loop, repeating until end of the slide. And then you can see that earth behind object, the 3D object, will get hidden during the slideshow after 2 seconds. And then immediately at the same time, the earth front object will get appear because of this appear animation that we have applied here. And that earth front is also having the same circle motion path with the same duration. So basically what I am doing, I have placed two objects around the sun, two different 3D models having exactly the same motion path length and having the same duration of the animation effect. So as in the beginning of this animation, what you see the earth coming behind from the sun. So that is why this earth behind 3D model is first in the list of the animation. Then after 2 seconds, this earth behind, the position is behind. So when it reaches at a certain point, after just 2 seconds, it gets disappeared, and then earth front, this one, because that object is in front of the sun. So that appear immediately when the earth behind gets disappear, and that object is also rotating with the same duration and with the same path. So what we are basically doing, we are showing one earth when it is coming from the behind, then we make it disappear, and then at the same time the earth front object is appearing, and it make a illusion that the earth is moving in front and back of the sun. So let me show you this slideshow. So using the same technique, you can add more 3D models to it, but as I have shown you that as the PowerPoint doesn't support graphic cards, so it gets slower and the animation lags a lot. So it is up to you if you want to add more planets to this animation. So I have just shown you a technique that how you can place one object in the front and in the back at the same time during the slideshow. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to my channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks.